don't need the word, for the promise in the name of Jesus. God, we can ask you right now, have your way, God. Let your word come forth in the name of Jesus. God, let this word go out, Lord Jesus. Find those who want to need to know this word. Give me your word, God. Your word said to return to you with reward, God. Your word should do what it said to accomplish, God. We ask in the name of Jesus that you would just have your way, God. That we decrease, that you increase in us right now. Lord, it's your will, God. We just ask these prayers and many more in Jesus' name. Thank God and amen. If you would turn with me into this 1 Samuel, the 13th chapter, 13 and 14 verse, and read on this wise. And Samuel said to Saul, that thou have done foolishly, thou have not kept the commandment of the Lord thy God, which he commanded thee, for now which the Lord has established thy kingdom upon Israel forever. But now thy kingdom shall not continue. The Lord has sought him a man after his own heart. And the Lord has commanded him to be captain over his people, because thou have not kept that which the Lord commanded thee. Lord, bless the readers and hearers of his word. The word of God is blessed. The title of this message is A Man After God's Own Heart. What's in your heart? Amen. Yes. A man after God's own heart. What's in your heart? Samuel basically was talking to Saul and telling Saul, you messed up. You did wrong. But he has to understand, it's in the heart of man. He said he finds a man after his own heart. This is God speaking. God went to Jeremiah, the 17th chapter, the 9th verse, 9th and 10th verse says, the heart is deceitful above all things, desperately wicked. Who can know it? I, the Lord, search the heart. I try the reins, even to give every man according to his works, and according to his ways, and according to the fruit of his doing. Romans 10, 9 and 10 says, thou, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thy heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. Matthew 22 and 36 through 38 says, Master, what is the greatest commandment in the law? Jesus said unto him, thou shalt love the Lord God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. So that means you have to love God with all of your heart, with all of your soul and all of your mind. That means you have to know, search your heart, what's in your heart. Luke 6 and 45 say, a good man out of the good treasure of his heart bringeth forth that which is good, an evil man out of the evil treasure of his heart bringeth forth that which is evil. For of the abundance of the heart, his mouth speaketh. So what's in your heart, your mouth going to speak. What's in you going to come out of you.
All right.
Matthew 6 and 19 says, lay not up for yourself treasure upon the earth, where moth and rust do corrupt, and where thieves break through and steal. But lay up for yourself treasure up in heaven, where neither moth nor rust do corrupt, where thieves do not break through nor steal. For where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. If we go back to 1 Samuel, here Samuel is talking to Saul, and he's telling him, you was foolish of what you did. But God said he sought a man after his own heart. He found somebody that could stand up for him. So he knew that this man was going to do this because of some things that was done in himself. But you realize this man, David, was a setup for success. He was set up to go through what he had to go through. But he wrote this in 51 Psalm. He wrote 5 through the 13th verse. He says,
He said, behold, I was shapen in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. Behold, I desire the truth in the inward part, in the hidden part, that I shall make me to know wisdom. Purge me with thy wisdom, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Make me to hear joy and gladness, that the bones which thou have broken may rejoice. Hide thy face from my sin. Blot out all my iniquity. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew the right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not the Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit. Then will I teach transgressors thy ways, and sinners shall be converted unto thee. And I just want to go back to that verse that says, create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew the right spirit. God must create in us. He must mold us. He must make us in the image that he wants us to be. He wants to be in the image of like Christ. He wants to be like Christ. He wants that this thing be crucified. No longer I, but the Christ on the inside. And we realize that God is soon to come back. And when he come back, he's searching the heart. You have to understand what is in your heart. If you realize who God really is, and you know that he's able to do what he says he's going to do, there's nothing too hard for our God. That you understand that David was basically saying, God, I can't do this. I need you to create in me. Oh, yeah, all this other stuff you did, God, but I want you to create in me. Yeah. I want you to mold me and make me and shape me so people will see that you are God and there's nobody higher than you. That you are the one that made the heaven and earth. You're the one spoke into existence. You're the one that breathed into a man's nostril and then became life. You're the one that created us. You're the one that put this heart in us. Let this heart of flesh be what you want it to be. Mold it and make it, God. But you took us out of muck and mire and placed our feet on the solid ground. You saved us from our sin and shame. When we came to you, God, we believe. Because when we believe, we can step out of faith because we believe what you have said in your word. If you said it, God, we can live by it because you are God all by yourself. And we realize what's in us because God said, I have found a man after my own heart. That has to mean something when you realize that God sees something in you that nobody else sees in you. And when God knows that you can be what he wants you to be, he can use you to a better place. You have to understand that God is trying to get us to a place in our life. Let me back up a little bit. David, when he went through his trouble, he went through his trouble because of what he saw through his eyes. He got his eyes off of Jesus. He got his eyes off of God. But I understand this. When you realize the relationship that you have with God, the heart begins to pump like it needs to. You begin to realize God is all I need. I don't need nothing else because of what Jesus did, because of God bringing, restoring back to David. He can teach transgressors their ways. He can tell sinners to come to Jesus. He can tell those ones that lost who God really is. When you realize in yourself there's nothing you can do but call on the name of Jesus. He said the word that we realize. If we realize who we are, Romans 10:9-10 said to tell us, for with the heart man believes unto righteousness, with the mouth confession made unto salvation, Lord. And we thank you, Lord Jesus, because of relationship. My heart is all before you. Create in me a clean heart and renew the right spirit, God. I want to be what you call me to be in these last and even days. People are scared, God. People are afraid, God. But God, I know, Lord, you continue, Lord Jesus. Look on your saints, God. And God, I thank you that you said your word, God. What two or three, Lord, is counted in your name. You in the midst, God. And I remember, Lord Jesus, how David, Lord Jesus, had messed up. But God, you restored him because he said to you, God, I messed up, God. I sinned before you. But when you realize in yourself there's nothing you can do, and you realize who God really is, and you realize that everything you need is in God, you lay aside every weight of sin and run the race that God put before you. You begin to check yourself. You begin to look at yourself. You begin to look at the mirror being the Bible. As you begin to look in the Bible, you find yourself in the Word of God. As you find yourself in the Word, as I hide the Word of my heart, that I may not sin against Him, I must hide the Word that on the inside. I must hide the Word. It was the Word of God that kept us. It was the Word of God that was made flesh. It was the Word of God. It came down through 42 generations. The Word of God. As I hide the Word in my heart, what's in your heart? You gotta understand. We know we're gonna have some problems. We're gonna have some troubles, tribulation in this world. But we have to realize one day, Lord, you're soon to come back. And when you come back, God, are you coming back for that church without a spot or wrinkle? God, we ask you that you will have your way.
I got a motion. All I have to say is, what's in your heart? What's in your heart? When you stop back and step back and look at yourself, realize who you are, who you belong to. When you realize God is God, there's nothing too hard for Him. When we realize because of who Jesus is, He paid the price for us. And I thought about when He decided to choose the disciples. Did He check their hearts? Did He look at them? Because I look at Judas, and I always look at Judas and say, why did He pick Judas? Knowing that Judas was going to do what he did, but why did He choose Judas? He chose Judas because there's a plan that God has for us. And we have to understand God knows everything. And I hear people say this all the time. God knows my heart. Yes, He do know your heart. But He wants you to change it. He wants you to hide the Word in your heart that you may not sin against Him. What's in your heart? Be blessed. Be blessed. Let me say a word of prayer. Father, I pray right now, whoever heard this, Lord, or whoever's listened to this message today, Lord, God, I pray right now that it will sanctify somebody, it will save somebody, it will change somebody's mind, God. God, it will fix their heart and begin to search their heart, God. God, they begin to look at themselves and, God, finding out how I can get closer to God. Lord, I pray right now in the name of Jesus that your will be done, God. In the name of Jesus, God, you move us out the way that we will glorify you, God. We lift you up, God. We pray right now for everyone that's listening or everyone that see this. God, I pray right now in the name of Jesus. And I thank you for my brother, God. Bless him the more, God. You see what he's trying to do. God, open up the wonders of heaven. What a blessing. We won't have room to receive. And we ask these prayers and many more. In Jesus' name, thank God.
You gotta live right. You got to live right. Walk right. Think about the move you made right today. If you want to be pleasing in the Lord's sight, you got to live right. If you wanna be pleasing in the Lord's sight.